disonorare la famiglia.
Llega así de esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Caballo le dan sabana, porque muy despreciado. Por eso no te perdono llorar. Ese amor llega así de esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Amor de compraventa, amor del pasado. Vendele, vendele, vendele.
Welcome. My name is Michael Hunter Schwartz, and I'm the Dean of the Law School. I want to give a special welcome to the loved ones and friends of our graduates. We are so glad you are here to celebrate with us. I will also ask my faculty colleagues and all the loved ones to join me in an enthusiastic congratulations of our graduates. We have a significant number of dignitaries that I need to recognize and welcome as present. So we have the Los Rios Community College Director of Prison and Reentry Education Program. Perhaps you know her as our former McGeorge Assistant Dean for Career Development, Molly Stafford. I was told, but I don't see, but I believe that somewhere around is the University of San Diego Assistant Dean for Admissions, Financial Aid, and Diversity Initiatives, Tracy Simmons, and our former McGeorge colleague in that role. But I don't see her. Well, she may be yet to appear, but I'm told she will be. The University of the Pacific co-chair for the Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Committee, Marche Pratt, is here today. An incredibly large chunk of my faculty colleagues, I'll ask you to each stand as I read your name. Larry Levine, our Associate Dean for Diversity. Ederlina Co. Mike Vitello. Melissa Brown. Stephanie Thompson. Blake Nordahl. Ron Hochbaum. Julie Davies. Aaron O'Neill Mullenberg. I didn't know she'd get that lot of a woo. Leah Adams. Lindsay Harrington. I know I saw her, but I don't know. Jocelyn Blinn. She's checking people in, so imagine that she's basking in your applause. Don Durenberg. And I feel like I was writing furiously, but I feel like I missed someone. So if I missed a faculty member, could you stand and accept my apology? Mary Beth Moylan. Apologies. If I missed anyone else. The Unity Graduation Planning Committee has asked me to begin with a land acknowledgement, and I am honored to do so. We acknowledge the land in which we are gathered to practice and enact meaningful change in the name of equity and inclusivity. This area is the land of the Nisenan people. We also acknowledge other tribes who stewarded this land, the Maidu, Potawatomi, Miwok, and Miwok tribes. These tribes have remained committed to the stewardship of this land over many centuries. The land has been cherished and protected as elders have instructed the young people through the generations. We are honored and we are grateful to be here today on their traditional lands. We encourage you to find out about the indigenous people on the land on which you stand today. It is my incredible honor to introduce our host for the festivities today. Isaiah Noel Crockran served McGeorge as third-year evening representative, fourth-year evening representative on the Student Bar Association, as well as co-president of the Black Law Student Association and co-chair of the McGeorge Unity Caucus. He worked throughout law school as a substance abuse counselor at California State Prison Solano, as well as helped launch the Community Impact Center, where he counseled and mentored youth of all ages. He is a professional development trainer, a life coach, a public speaker of 13 years, a university lecturer, a recorded spoken word artist, a minister, and an activist throughout Greater Sacramento. But before all else, he is a servant leader with a heart for the McGeorge community. On a personal level, it's been a great joy to get to work with, learn from, and build a relationship with this man. He is smart, he is direct, he is funny, he is honest, and he is committed to justice. He is the rare person who is as willing to confront justice as he is playful. I will genuinely miss him. Folks, please join me in welcoming Isaiah to the podium.
that music is fire. Y'all like that? Who was that? Who put that playlist on? What's up, McGeorge 2022? All right, so the energy that y'all welcomed me with is the energy that we're gonna carry the entire night, because this is a celebration. Somebody say, celebrate.
Celebrate.
Over here say, celebrate.
Celebrate.
And the theme of what we're doing tonight is unity. Somebody say, unity.
Unity.
All right, so as he mentioned, Dean Schwartz mentioned, I have a history as a minister. So in the Black church, we do a little call and response, right? As Kendra knows, she feels it. That's right. So when I say unity, you're going to respond with? Some of y'all been to church, it's okay. When I say celebrate, you're going to respond with?
Celebrate.
But with a little you're going to say, celebrate.
Celebrate.
Unity.
Unity.
Celebrate.
Celebrate.
All right, that energy, keep it the whole, who was that? Whose kid is that? That's right, kid to celebrate. So I have the honor and the privilege of emceeing tonight's events. I do think that it is an honor and a privilege, being that for most of my career here, I told a couple of you all, I didn't think anyone knew me. And that's what it means to be an evening student. You kind of tuck away and you do the work. You show up when class is in session. You disappear into the library. You've got to work. Some of us, you know, have had full-time careers, or maybe we've been raising families, things of that nature. Not to say anything different than the day program, but again, I just didn't know that I had a presence here on campus. And it became important to assume whatever role that I knew that I was going to walk into when I left this campus, right? Now, my mom is here. Go ahead and raise your hand, Mom. My mom, from the moment we walked on campus, many of you were, oh, you must be so proud of your son. And eventually she's like, okay, he needs to be humbled. So the task for you all is to tell my mom one thing about me to humble me. So tonight's going to be a celebration, not because of any of the amount of events or things we have planned. We have some great things planned. I hear our keynote speaker, Darrin, he's going to take us home. I hear we've got some performances. I hear our diversity representatives are going to speak tonight. We've got some videos to show. A lot of things planned tonight, but that's not what's going to make tonight special. What makes tonight special is that you carry the attitude of celebration and of unity, of inclusion throughout the event. And that when you leave the event, you carry it with you into bar prep, because it should remind you why you came here and why you decided to torture yourself the way you will over the next 2 months. It should remind you why we sacrificed so much, right? Because we did, we all did, in our own individual ways. There was a sacrifice here, but we get to enjoy that. So enjoy it. That's my challenge for you tonight, all right? One more time, unity.
Unity.
Celebrate.
Celebrate.
Now we just need an organ and we can go home. It's good. So I have the honor of inviting up our very first speaker, right? So I'm going to read the bio that's in front of me, because I think it's actually pretty fantastic. And I think it'll give you an awareness of who you're about to hear from. So Kishwer Vikaas is an attorney practicing in Sacramento, whose recent position was as a staff attorney at the McGeorge Immigration Clinic in fall of 21, where she helped supervise students as they worked on cases involving asylum, detention, and more. Ms. Vikaas also taught legal research and writing to McGeorge LLM students as an adjunct professor. She is a California State Bar Certified Law Specialist in Immigration and Nationality Law. Before joining McGeorge, Ms. Vikaas practiced immigration law at Opening Doors, a nonprofit serving refugees and survivors of human trafficking. Prior to that, she worked at Legal Services of Northern California in health law. A Philadelphia native, as am I, as is my mother. Woot woot, Philly. That's right. A Philadelphia native, Ms. Vikaas graduated with a BA in English and a JD from Temple University, where she was an evening student. Shout out to evening students. She is currently, yeah, y'all feel it. She is currently Secretary of the Asia Pacific Bar Association of Sacramento and the NorCal Law Student Co-Coordinator of the American Immigration Lawyers Association. In 2019, she was named one of Sacramento Business Journal's 40 Under 40 honorees. She was also recognized by Sacramento's Unity Bar with the Community Service Award for her work with victims of violence. Before becoming an attorney, Ms. Vikaas was a writer whose jobs included working for MTV. That's pretty dope. Please join me in welcoming Kishwer Vikaas to the stage.
This is my favorite song, actually. How did you know? Good evening to all of you beautiful people gathered here today at our annual Unity graduation. Thank you so much to the planning committee, Dean Fernandez, Dean Schwartz, and everyone who made today happen. A warm welcome to all the family, the friends, the chosen family here to mark this momentous occasion. It truly takes a village. My name is Kishwer Vikaas, and I've had the joy of getting to know many of you graduates over the past few years. Today, it's an honor to celebrate your accomplishments. You did it. You did it, class of 2022. You did it. You persevered through a once-in-a-century pandemic, conflicts around the world and here, and countless other disruptions and tragedies. You kept your eyes on the prize. You truly are your ancestors' wildest dreams. It wasn't easy, and you might be tired now, but you did it. And here you are, the 2022 class of future esquires and change makers. I couldn't be prouder. Nine years ago, I was in your seat, the first person in my family to graduate from college and graduate school in America. My parents immigrated from Pakistan, where they were minorities facing constant persecution. After they came to America, my family initially struggled. My dad worked as a security guard, and my mom cleaned houses for $5 an hour. I remember standing in line for food stamps. Until I started law school, I didn't really know a single lawyer. So here's three things I wish I would have known then. Number one, cultivate a rest practice. Now, I know y'all are hard workers, obviously, and you're gonna be zealous, dedicated advocates for your clients, but hear me out. Lawyers are notorious for overworking. Bloomberg Law did a survey recently that found 52% of attorneys were feeling burned out right now. A social worker once told me, "You can't help anyone if you don't help yourself." That's become my mantra. My dear graduates, my new colleagues, this great profession, which comes with so much privilege and the power to change lives, so much responsibility, it's a marathon, not a sprint. It's a high-stress profession where more than one in five attorneys end up with substance abuse issues. So cultivate a healthy rest practice now. As an intern, I remember coming out of the Philadelphia Family Court where I had to file a case, and I literally had the flu, and the entire office applauded me. Our profession applauds sacrifice, toughness. It's our normal. It's the toxic part of lawyer culture. Okay, so for your homework, write this down. I want all of you to follow on Instagram, the Nap Ministry. Now, rest isn't just about naps, although naps are great too. Rest is a form of resistance. Ironically, I first learned this lesson when I was a health attorney, working all hours of the day and night. To my shock, I ended up in the hospital. It's not worth it. Remember, you worked too hard for this degree. Number two, cultivate a practice of joy. Like rest, joy is another form of resistance first articulated by Black scholars in the 60s. A Harvard study found that joy, more so than genetics, positively influences health emotionally, physically, and socially. Law has historically not been a welcoming place for many of us. I can't tell you the number of times I've walked into court and the judge has mistaken me for an interpreter or a client. But as Shirley Chisholm says, if they don't give you a seat at the table, bring a folding chair. For example, in 1878, Clara Foltz, the first woman admitted to the California bar, had to sue to attend law school and get a bill passed to take the bar. Many years later, 2014, Sergio Garcia, the first undocumented attorney in California, had to file a lawsuit and also get a bill signed by the governor. Breaking ceilings, like you folks are doing today, takes work and energy. Being a trailblazer can rob you of your joy. Macroaggressions, microaggressions rob you of your joy, compounded by generational trauma and the trauma being profiled and policed. But the practice of joy is about intentionally creating spaces to counter that joy. Make the joyous moments in your life a priority. I'm going to be a mom now. Take time for your family celebrations, your community celebrations, your personal celebrations. Don't let anyone steal your joy. And finally, organize. Best friends Anne Friedman and Aminata Sow coined the idea of shine theory to help address the gender gap. The idea is simple. The success of your peers should empower your own. Like the rapper Fabulous sings, if I shine, you shine. Class of 2022, as you leave these doors, you're gonna see each other rise and maybe fall down and rise again. But under shine theory, you will be more successful if you cooperate rather than compete. A practice of mutual investment in each other. As you begin your careers, stay connected with your classmates. Go with them to the Unity Bar Associations in your city. If your city doesn't have one, start one. Talk about your salaries. Be transparent about toxic spaces. Share information. Leverage it so you can rise together, shine together. Thank you and congratulations.
Kishwer, that was beautiful. Thank you so much. I think I'm a huge fan of the shine theory, especially, you know, when we recognize that none of us did this by ourselves, right? And I think you, with firsthand knowledge of everything you shared, it takes a community to get where we've come. None of us did it alone. So see each other as colleagues, see each other as friends, see each other as resources as we move forward in this journey, because we're going to need each other. And as I'm told, the legal community is small in Sacramento, so don't make any enemies tonight, all right? So we're going to move on, but before we do, I'm told Dean Simmons is in the house. Can we give it up for Dean Simmons? See, Dean Simmons is visiting us from San Diego, but this gets to be her second home because she went back home to be with family and to continue on things that she built. And we know that that community there is very, very privileged, very blessed to have you in the same way that we were blessed to have you for over a decade. And in the same way that I was blessed to have you as a mentor here and as an advisor to the Black Law Student Association and to the Unity Caucus. So I'm giving you a personal thanks for being here in the building. I want you to meet my mama pretty soon. Y'all both in San Diego, so it's going to be lovely. Go have tea, get some breakfast. It's going to be great. I'll come see you soon. All right, so we're going to move on with our scheduled events. Next, we're going to have a performance. I'm really, really excited. But now I have to practice my Spanish. So this is, I'm going to pronounce this and then run out of the way from embarrassment. The performance is by the Instituto Mazatlan Bellas Artes de Sacramento. And somebody's going to riddle me for not pronouncing that correctly later. Give it up, y'all.
Yo soy cansado, y hoy otra vez me has engañado.
Give it up one more time, y'all. Give it up. Give it up. Man, I wish my gown looked at... We're not done. Oh, wow. Excuse me. Y'all don't need to see me.
A mi negra que la quiero ver aquí con su rebozo de seda que le traje de Tepí. Cuando me traes a mi negra que la quiero ver aquí con su rebozo de seda que le traje de Tepí. Thank you.
Hey, in law school, they teach you not to make the same mistake twice, so I had to wait that time. You get dinged for it. If you have Dean Levine, you get a big no on your exam. You guys having fun? Let me hear from our family and friends. Y'all having fun?
Yeah.
All right, we love that. So I want to introduce to you someone who is special to my heart as a friend and a brother. This person could not be here tonight, wanted to very, very badly, but they are a responsible human who just happened to get COVID. So I don't think he would mind me sharing that because he'll probably just take it out on me in boxing at 6 a.m. So Michael Dastas is, yeah, go ahead. You're right. Yeah. We love Mike. He's the homie. Michael Dastas served this present year as a diversity chair. So he sat on SBA as a liaison to the Unity Caucus. And in doing so, he got to be a voice for so many of us and for so many individuals who would otherwise be marginalized in communities throughout McGeorge. Mike is a dear brother of mine, not because he puts his best self forward when we're in communication or when we're in class or when we're boxing at 6 a.m. as we actually do, or when we're serving in our capacities on SBA or in Unity Caucus. Mike just is, and that's what made him great. That's what makes him great. That's what's going to make him great. And so I believe that Michael was able to channel that in his friendships with all of us, right, throughout this school year and in the previous years as well. So although Mike could not be here and present with us in person tonight, Mike recorded a video because he wanted to share some of his thoughts from the position and role as diversity chair. And I personally can't wait to hear what he has to say. So without further ado, let's listen up to Michael Dastas.
Hello and welcome to the 2022 Unity graduation. My name is Michael Dastas and I helped plan this event. I was hoping to speak in front of you in person, but unfortunately I have COVID. So I thought it'd be better if I recorded my speech and presented it to you. I'd like to dedicate this speech to my father, Jose Alberto Dastas Caballero. Unfortunately, he could not be with us today, but his spirit lives on through me. Today, I feel closer to my father than I have ever felt in my life. 2 days prior to the start of my 2L year, I received news that would alter the rest of my law school career. My father had died suddenly of a heart attack. I struggled mightily with these last 2 years, but I never gave up because my father taught me the importance of paciencia y fe. This Spanish phrase means literally patience and faith. For many Latinx people, this phrase is often the only hope that we have when the world is stacked against us. When we are worried about paying for rent or groceries or our children, we cling to the paciencia y fe that God has a plan and everything will be all right. Many times we say this phrase as a prayer that tomorrow God will act through someone to alleviate our pain and anguish. My father came to the United States from Guanica, Puerto Rico, with no money or family, and he only knew two English words, hamburger and chicken. My father served in the U.S. Navy and struggled to learn the language. Once he left the Navy, my father tried to obtain his contractor's license and was denied because he spoke with a heavy accent. My father proceeded to earn a doctorate in pharmacy from the University of Pacific and later a medical degree from the Southwest College of Naturopathic Medicine in Phoenix, Arizona. Orgulloso, or proud, is how my father felt when he found out that I got into McGeorge. And if he were here today, I bet he would be orgulloso to see me graduate. It is because of his tireless work that I was able to grow into the man that I am today. My father earned all that equity just to share with me. He instilled in me a love for community and a responsibility to give back whenever I could. Equity to me is justice free from bias or favoritism that works to override systems of discrimination and bigotry. Often sharing equity is when employers offer positions or education to people from historically disadvantaged groups. Other examples include charitable giving or supporting local small businesses like those found here in Oak Park. My father needed someone to share some of their equity with him. The irony is that my father was always the one sharing equity with anyone who needed help. He would work so hard to earn money to feed his family and those in the community that he knew were struggling because he had been denied equity so often. As I go forward in my career, I plan to work in immigration law. My hope is to make that equity that my father gave me spread to our community. I hope to see many of my fellow graduates follow me in my efforts to share our equity. The legal profession is particularly small, so it is up to us to make a difference. I encourage everyone graduating today to pursue pro bono and public interest work sometime in their careers, because your work can bring lasting generational wealth and positive change. This is for my family in Puerto Rico. Yo seré puertorriqueño por donde quiera que ande, porque lo llevo en mi sangre por la herencia de mis padres. Thank you for your time and congratulations to the class of 2022.
Hey, Mike's story is a reminder that we all have a story, right? We all do have a story. And it's those unique struggles that we pushed through law school with. We didn't put those struggles or that story to the side. We carried it with us. And we are, as was spoken over us earlier, ooh, that was fancy. We are our ancestors' wildest dreams, right? Okay, let's keep going. Well, I don't want to introduce this person. I want to welcome them first. Sofia, you want to come on up? Come on. I gotta tell her, don't cry, from what I'm about to say. Real quick, though, before I introduce Sofia, the dancing just reminded me. Dean Schwartz said that I am also playful. It's probably because someone dared me to dance on him at the reception the other day, and I did it. And he danced back. It was great. Yeah, I loved it. Okay, so back to our scheduled events. So Sofia is a friend of mine, and the reason why I don't want to introduce her is because, come closer. I want to speak to her, right? So you know that I have a history as a minister, and occasionally in that role, a person is responsible to speak words of affirmation and encouragement over those in community there. You as my friend, as my sister, as a colleague, as a person who I trust with my whole life, I'm being honest, right? I think the kinds of things that you've been tasked with supersede law school. Does that make sense? The kinds of things that you've been tasked with go far beyond this season or this struggle, right? Thank you. And the thing about it is that Sofia knows it because she's been operating in what I just said the entire time we've been here. And so to be a woman of color, right? To have descendants not from this country, to every space you go in, either by choice or by force, you are representing those individuals. You have stepped up to the plate more often than any individual can count. That's why I said don't cry, because this is on my heart to say, right? And I got the mic, so I'm gonna say it. I just want the room to know what kind of presence is being felt in going out of McGeorge. And you carried so many of us. All right.
Okay, I'm gonna cry.
All right, I'm gonna stop this so you don't cry. Well, you are appreciated, and I look forward to hearing all that you have to share and all that you're going to commit to doing in the years to come. So, warm welcome to Sofia.
Oh my God. Thank you so much. I feel the same way, Isaiah. We met 2L year, and I just felt I have my person, someone who has my back, who will speak up when I cannot speak up. So thank you so much for that warm welcome. So good evening, faculty, staff, colleague, friends, and foremost, my family. My name is Sofia Schersei, and I'm humbled to stand before you today as a 2022 first-generation graduate JD student. I'm a proud Muslim American and Afghan American daughter of immigrants who came to the States for the American dream. I also dedicate this speech to my parents and family who are sitting right there. Many times we celebrate the students, but it truly is about our support system today. My parents left everything behind in Afghanistan and started a new life for my siblings and I. We came from nothing and had very little. However, I grew up thinking I did not have anything less than everyone else. It wasn't until senior year when my counselor grabbed me out of class and asked me if I was okay. I did not know what she meant by that. And because she looked at my FAFSA application, she saw that my family made less than $39,000 for a household of five people. And she said, how do you operate? Do you have clothes? Do you have anything? And I had no idea because I felt I lived like a queen and princess in my household. I let her know that I'm doing just fine and that I'm on top of my grades. But quickly I realized that my mom became a master of payment plans and stretching a dollar really, really wide to shield us of how little we had. My parents always strived for the best and pushed us to acquire an education. My ancestors came from rich and wealthy backgrounds in Afghanistan, but the war tore everything and we were displaced and thousands of Afghans were displaced. Therefore, my mom and father would always tell me, Bachem, dars bakhon, dars bakhon, dars bakhon. Hech kase digrita namitana bigira. And that means, my child, study, study, study. No one can take it away from you. According to my parents, education was the one thing, no matter where you go, which country you go, which language you speak, whether you lose all your wealth or not, no one can take that degree in education away from you. This degree that we all are about to receive this Saturday is something that you can carry for a lifetime. It might sound cliche, but it truly took a village to get us here, especially for underrepresented individuals like us standing here today. Mom, I wanted to take a moment and thank you for everything. When we moved to the States, when we moved to the States, I did not know any English. You were the only one who spent your teenhood here in the United States. You shared your knowledge and committed yourself to my success. Thank you for those late nights staying up with me and translating the text out of my AP history and AP literature book to translate from English to German and to sit down with me while I was writing my German essay to translate it back into English, just so that my teachers could understand my thoughts from the homework and so that I could get those A's. You stood up with me until 4 a.m. each night until I could do it on my own for several years, and you never gave up on me. I'll never forget your help and care. This hat belongs to you. Yeah. Sorry, it's very emotional. Dad, thank you for working late night shifts and for always providing, even if we had nothing. We never had enough money to buy the fancy stuff, but you always told us that you will work extra shifts, that we can have the best pens, the best books, the best posters for school, and then this robe belongs to you. You two are my rock and role models. I would be nothing without you two. I cannot leave the stage without also acknowledging my amazing husband, Gauss. You're my best friend. You're my best friend, my confidant and partner in crime. You have seen me cry, struggle, and doubt myself. You've never failed to amaze me with your comforting words. Thank you for helping me in acquiring this degree. Your labor of love allowed me to focus on my scholarship. I know that many of us here sitting tonight have similar background of struggles and obstacles that pushes us to work harder, push harder, and study harder. Today is about celebrating all of us. So I want to take a moment and ask some of you to stand up to show who's in the room. So if you are first generation, please stand up. Wow, these are my friends, everyone. Okay. If you are a child of immigrant, please stand up or remain stood up. If you're a child of immigrants. Okay. If your parents had to work various jobs to provide for you to get here, please stand up. If you have ever felt imposter syndrome, please stand up. So, a note to my colleagues. This is the very same room we came as one else, not knowing what we're doing, doubting ourselves. Our family members came 3 years ago when we got pinned, and here you are today, standing successful, no matter all the doubt and obstacles you have faced. So give yourself an applause. This should be a living proof to never doubt yourself and to remember this moment that no matter what comes your way in the legal profession, that you better step up and take the challenge and take that win. And so that we can help the next Michael Dastas, the next Isaiah, the next Sophia, and we're the first of many, but we're paving that path. So congratulations, class of 2022, and thanks for having me.
And keep that going. This is how we do it. Yeah. Oh, somebody had it. Who had my back? Who was that? Clayson. I'm too much sometimes. Okay, we're going to keep going. Wasn't that beautiful, y'all? Didn't y'all love that? We're going to keep going. So our keynote. We got one more thing before we bring. You ready though? You gonna match my energy? I told you. You gotta match this energy. You gotta match that energy too, brother. You gotta do it all. Okay, we'll give you a break then. We got one more thing coming. Y'all should never put me up here. Okay, we're gonna keep it going and having some fun. Somebody say unity.
Unity.
Somebody say celebrate.
Celebrate.
Awesome. So the very next thing, we've got some thank you videos. So we've got those queued up. Let's go ahead and show those.
Hi, my name is Shisha Yang, and I just want to say thank you to my parents. Thank you to my family. I'm so grateful to have you by my side, especially to my parents for your unconditional support, for my partner Edgar, for your patience.
I want to express my thanks to my mentors, my friends, my family, and most of all, my dog, Ben.
So my law school experience, I've had a number of people in my community come alongside me over these last 4 years. Some of that support that they've shown has been financial. It's been their time as I vent about the law school experience.
Hello everyone, thank you all for celebrating this joyous yet melancholy occasion with me. There are a few people whom I would not have survived this far without that I'd love to share my gratitude with.
I would like to thank both my parents, Farzan and Awabi, and my father, Badalai Sherzai. If it wasn't for you all sacrificing and putting your sweat, blood, and tears into all of us by raising us and pushing us to go to school, I would not be here today.
I'd like to first thank my family for being my biggest support system throughout my law school journey.
Hi, my name is Michael Garcia. First off, I would like to thank my parents, Tony and Linda Garcia. Thank you for all of your endless love and support. Without you, none of this would have been possible. I would have never finished law school.
When looking back on who I'm grateful for during law school, I'm grateful for my family and for my friends that have been patient with me in the time that I've needed to get my work done.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for just always being there for me and being my biggest support system throughout law school. I couldn't have made it this far without you two. So thank you for everything you've done for me. I also want to say thank you to my siblings. Thank you for just being there and supporting me with, you know, all the food and snacks that you provided over the past couple of years. So, thank you. And your little sister has made it.
I'd also like to thank the rest of my family, my sister Mia, my grandmother, and all of my aunts. It took a village.
It is your sacrifices that I stand here graduating with a Juris Doctor. Last but not least, I wanted to thank my husband, Michael Hunter Schwartz. The last 3 years, we've gone through a lot. You've seen me cry, you've seen me stress, not sleeping, but you've always stuck to my side as my husband. And so this is for both of us, and I cannot wait to celebrate our future together.
Alicia, thank you for being more than just my sister and being my mom, best friend, and rock throughout my entire time here. Mommy and Papa, thank you so much for your sacrifices and guidance. Teeps, thank you so much for being the shoulder for me to cry on all these years. Thank you to Binu Mama for flying all the way from Fiji to witness this moment with us. I'm missing you heavy right now, Bobifua, as well as all the family we've lost these past couple of years. But I hope you all are watching proudly and happily wherever you may be.
They have given me endless support and have lifted me up whenever I was doubting myself throughout this time.
Thank you to all my friends here in law school and not in law school.
I'm most grateful for my peers that have stood by my side and helped me through some of the toughest times of my life, but also who have supported me in endeavors that I felt needed to be supported.
I would also like to thank the friends that I've made here. I don't think I could have done it without you guys. And lastly, I'd like to thank McGeorge for giving me the opportunity to make my dreams come true. So thank you all.
Thank you to all those who've doubted me. Your words will continuously light a fire in me to prove you wrong. Thank you to all my ancestors who survived 31 famines, slavery, and colonization. To all the graduates who are listening, we are truly our ancestors' wildest dreams. Last but not least, thank you, Krishna, for always being the light in my heart and the wisdom in my mind. Without you, none of this would be possible. Jai Shri Krishna.
And thank you to all the faculty, staff, and professors that supported me here in law school, especially Professor Co, Molly, Isabella. I'm really grateful for all of you.
I'd like to thank all the professors that helped me along the way, but especially thank you to Professor Salcido. Thank you, Professor Adams. Thank you, Professor Mullenberg, for being a fantastic appellate advocacy coach and always believing in me. Finally, thank you so much, Professor Croxwell, for all the mentorship and advice you gave me.
So thank you to both my family and friends for coming out and always supporting me.
Law school is tough. None of us have been able to do this on our own. And I truly am grateful for the community that I found in this experience, as well as those who have championed me along the way years before they got me to go to law school in the first place.
Momta said, let my haters be my motivators. She was bold too. I love it. So we're gonna keep going. Before we keep going, I truly do hope you sense our sense of gratitude for championing us and as our community, as our family, as our friends. Hey, this shit was tough. Can I say that? It was tough. I've done a lot of hard things in my life. My whole family has. But this was by far the most difficult thing I've ever done. And I'm not just glad that it's over. I'm glad for the person that I became, right? And that person, that's why I'm grateful, because you helped to form that person. And I think many of my colleagues feel the same way. So again, thank you, family, friends. Let's give it up, a hand. Thank you all for being present with us. So I'm not going to be dramatic and flashy when I introduce you. Is that okay? I want to give you time to create the palette that we're going to. I'm going to read from the, in other words, I'm going to read straight from the paper for, for our keynote speaker. I want to introduce you to Darrin Lim of 2004. For our keynote speaker tonight, Darrin graduated from McGeorge in 2004, and he proudly represented his class as the graduation speaker. He spoke about lust, passion, and love. The lust for education, the passion for success, and the love and support of friends and a family. Mr. Lim is the co-founder of Politicom Law. Politicom is a woman and minority-owned firm in the San Francisco Bay Area. The firm specializes in political compliance and represents some of the largest companies throughout the country. Mr. Lim is an active member of McGeorge's Diversity Board, and outside of his work, he and his husband are the proud dads of two young children. Tonight, Mr. Lim shares insights into his professional journey and the power of turning the page and writing your own future. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Darrin Lim.
Thank you so much, Isaiah, for that beautiful introduction and for hosting such an inspired evening. Dean Schwartz, McGeorge community, friends, family, and especially the 2022 graduates of McGeorge School of Law. I am truly inspired and humbled to be in your company on this night. I'm honored that you've asked me to share a few words and to look out and see all of these faces in person after 2 years of being stuck behind a laptop. It feels so special to be here tonight. It's special because it's a signal that maybe, just maybe, we are turning a page. Turning a page. And to the class of 2022, turning the page in your life from being students to your future as graduates. Turning the page to the bar exam. That's a big page. That's a big page. But turning the page, ultimately, to your careers and a world of possibilities. So why am I here? I'm here to represent as a minority attorney, a gay attorney, an Asian attorney. I'm also here to represent humbly as an attorney who is more successful and happier than I could ever have imagined. I don't say that boastfully. That's not me. But happiness and success, that combination, it doesn't happen that often. But I want to be here tonight to share it is absolutely possible. As I was preparing for these remarks, I came across this article about mentorship. And this article presented various perspectives. One writer poo-pooed passion. Another writer focused exclusively on hard work. I was conflicted reading that article because for me, my road to happiness, my road to success, it was paved with passion and hard work. I learned about hard work very, very early in my career. In fact, it came about, that lesson, it came about because of a big, fat, miserable failure. Yeah, you heard me. Big, fat, miserable failure. I'm about to share something I have never discussed in a setting like this. I failed the bar. F, failure, loser, go back to jail. Why am I telling you this tonight? Because back then, I graduated with honors. You heard that I was the graduation speaker. I actually practiced my speech way back when in this very room. I landed a job at a top firm. My first office as a lawyer overlooked the water on the precipice of happily ever after. My dream was crumbling. I had never failed in my life. I mean, sure, I was not good at math and science, which is why I'm an attorney. But I had never failed. But that F, that failure, it pushed me to study harder. I was forced to study harder than I'd ever studied in my life, because you know what? My life depended on it. I studied to the point where I felt like a human robot. And it kind of felt good because I had challenged myself in a way that I had never challenged myself before, academically or mentally. I certainly don't want any of you to fail the bar. That's not why I'm telling you the story. But I know in your legal careers, you will face setbacks. You will face your moment. And I want to reassure you, failure can be a gift. Failure can be a gift. It's a gift when you learn from your mistakes. I mean, that's why they call it the practice of law. I mean, a really good attorney has messed up many times, but learned from each one of those mistakes. And I'm certainly a better attorney today, having failed the bar, because I don't take my career for granted. So let's talk about your careers. As a diverse attorney, I know what it's like to step in to that legal world. I've been there. I know what it's like to step into old school worlds where white Ivy League establishment, where they devalued my worth and questioned my value. It was totally cool when I was the worker bee, toiling away. But when I decided it was time for me to step into the light, oh no, that was too much. How could a gay Asian attorney ever connect to clients in the same way that a white Ivy League straight man could connect to clients? I am here to share, graduates. Affirmatively, yes. Yes. Clients will connect to you when you are working hard and you're doing what you love, because they will see it. They will feel it. they will gravitate towards you because they will see you in the light that I'm seeing you tonight. And that is the best. You can absolutely be the best. It's so wonderful to be surrounded with friends, family, relatives. If you are a family member, if you are a friend, stand up. Stand up. Thank you for your efforts. Now, let's return it to the graduates. Let's give our graduates a huge round of applause. Graduates, you heard that applause, but did you feel it? I want you to feel it, because as you turn this next page, I want you to turn it with confidence. Turn that page with conviction. I want you to turn that page ready to work hard, but also be open and turning that page to finding your passion in the law. Your journeys, your stories will be varied, and it can be complicated at times, but that's okay. And if you ever stumble, know that that stumble could be the best thing that ever happens on your journey to happiness and success. Graduates, chapters of possibilities await you. I challenge you to write your story. I challenge you to write your future. And in all of this, write you. All of us tonight, all of us, we cannot wait to read your powerful story. Congratulations.
You want to DJ a party for me, bro? Yeah. Come on, man. Man, I needed you for my 30th birthday party. That was awesome. Darrin Lim, we appreciate you. We appreciate everything you shared and the encouragement that came. Let's give a round of applause one more time. Thank you, brother. So we're about to move into a very special time. We would describe this time as a pinning ceremony. Excuse me, I lost my words. This will be a pinning ceremony. This moment is where you, as family members, get to participate in a very symbolic, very emotional, very real, meaningful way with your graduate. So, how many of you received the little red ticket? I'm gonna raise those tickets up. Family members, do you all have a red ticket? So if you received a red ticket, your graduate chose you to be the individual to place a stool around them in this upcoming part of our event tonight. So what I'm gonna have you all do is get up out of your seats and prepare to transition, right? So we're gonna try to do this as cleanly as possible. I have some instructions, but they're my text messages, so I have to, gotta go look at it. So my graduates, you all are going to come and line up Alaska Airlines fashion, to my left, your right, according to your number. So feel free to do that now. Family members who have, starting with at the back, who are you? What are you? Perfect. Families, you're going to come this way. We've got a host waiting for you on this side, starting at the top there. Graduates, you'll make your way, climb the steps. Family members, you'll do the same. Headed to my right, your left. Our DJ is about to take it home. Can y'all feel this? My feet is moving. He feels it. Look, he feels it.
Hello, everyone. I'm Associate Dean Mary Beth Moylan. I'm taking this off while I read. How much better is that? Okay. thanks. So I'm going to read each graduate's name as they come down. They will meet with their family member for the pinning in the middle, and we're just going to take one by one. So let's get started. Justin Lee. Good luck, he says. Oh, I can do it. Although your handwriting is not great, but this is Jordan Mikkel Nielmeyer. Nielmeyer?
Pretty good.
All right, yeah. Say it again. Niemöller, sorry. Mikkel Niemöller, yay. This is Shusha Yang. Congratulations. Nice to see you. Maria Lamberson. Jose Torres. Oh, I know you, Amit. Amit Sharma. Michael Garcia with his dad. Mark Bennett. Alexander Voronsov. Alyssa Nicole Eccles. genetics. Okay, Vivian Sarek. Melissa Hurtado Valdez and her mom. Kajal Patel. Lansky. Oh, that's very sweet. You guys, so cute. Senia Kochneva. Conchita Gonzalez. Mobala. I've only said that right this one time in all these years, but yay. Sofia Schersei with her mom. Najakadia with family. Isaiah Crockran. Our next graduate, it is her birthday, so we need to give an extra special cheer, and yes, her mom told me. Okay, Kanarik Melkonyan. And happy birthday. the phonetics are confusing me more. I'm like, I know how to say this. Okay, Flora Fazy. Milad Ryan Sefidpour. Your SBA president, Michael Chrysostomo. Jackson with Professor Adams. Sabina Leimuller. Zara Nagavian. Mamta Singh. Okay, that's a talent. Arantxa Gonzalez. Okay. Juan Misal Gutierrez Rivera.
Let's give one more round of applause. Wasn't that special? But here's the thing, we're not done yet. Can somebody say the party continues? Somebody say celebrate.
Celebrate.
Unity.
Unity.
Celebrate.
Celebrate.
Unity.
Unity.
So I don't have an introduction for you. I think this next section will speak for itself. So, without further ado, I want to introduce you to you, DJ Afghan Lounge.
شب ما منوار حرف هست توی اون شب ما منوار حرف هست عشق من ها عشق من بیا برقصیم که من نازیم شبست عشق من بیا برقصیم که من نازیم شبست توی اون شب ما منوار حرف هست توی اون شب ما منوار حرف هست نام خدا
tío y no tenés que aquí a esta nena. ¿Quién puede parar eso que al bailar descontrola tus caderas? Y ese fuego que quema por dentro y lento te convierte en piedra. Con la mano arriba, cintura sola, da media vuelta y sacude el culo. No te quite ahora, que todo solo empieza.
Toronto, Tokyo.
من فقط تو رو دوست دارم عزیزم توکیو. دوست داری منو
نفس روانیتم نفس. وقتی خیر میدی وسطنه یه پا کایلی جنری ولایی گونگون جون قایی یه چه هیکلی داری بایی تهران دافشم گنگه و شاخ نشو برو دیایی تو لیان شام کوری آره ما بلین جک بکو پاره ببین دادا من خیلی هایم چوچ
من همه جور پایم
بشین جایین که با ما بحث کنی برو سور و سات و سلطان رو بچین اون بیتن بیتن از تهران تا توکیو
من فقط تو رو دوست دارم عزیزم توکیو
وای بیتن بیتن از تهران تا توکیو
من فقط تو رو دوست دارم عزیزم توکیو.
So, do y'all remember when I told y'all this was gonna be like the black church? Hey, we need those MLK fans that we be having in the pews. Hey, we might as well have gone to Faces. That was so much dancing. I love that. That was. What y'all doing later? So we're gonna continue with the scheduled events. I was telling a few people. That's never happened here before. My encouragement, I'm going to turn everything into a law school thing. My encouragement is that you all be trendsetters like you just were on this dance floor. Come on now. Let's celebrate culture, right? Afghan style. All right, so I'm going to give y'all a chance to fan yourselves and cool down and check those Instagram lives and make sure nothing crazy happened. I'm going to introduce our next speaker. Her reputation as a professor here at McGeorge precedes her, and it's been a pleasure to be at this institution simultaneous to her. I know that the work that many professors do go unnoticed, but Professor Co's work does not. We definitely notice the work that you've done and who you are as a person and as an advocate to us as law students, as people first, and definitely to us as a resource in the legal profession. So I'm gonna read your bio, but I wanted to say that first. We are truly grateful for you tonight. So Professor Ederlina Co teaches global lawyering skills, reproductive rights and justice, and the Prisoner Civil Rights Mediation Clinic. Her research is focused on issues that arise in the area of reproductive rights and justice. Before joining the faculty, Professor Co gained extensive experience as an attorney in the private and public sectors. This year, she received Pacific's Woman of Distinction Award, the Heather C. McFarlane Teaching Innovation Award, and the Public Legal Service Society's Faculty Member of the Year Award. Please give a warm welcome to Professor Co.
Thank you.
I'm going to try and get through this without crying, looking at you all. Thank you to Isaiah. Thank you to Kim Miller and Cassandra Fernandez and the entire Unity Graduation Planning Committee for inviting me to help close out what has been a truly wonderful ceremony. And thank you to everyone for being here to help honor and celebrate the graduates tonight. So when I started thinking about what I would say in my final address to the class of 2022, naturally I took some time to reflect on everything that we've experienced in the last 3 or 4 years together. Most notably, we've had the COVID-19 pandemic, which sadly has taken more than 1 million people from us in the United States since it started. We've experienced an intense racial reckoning as a result of police-involved killings and a surge in race-related hate crimes. And we've experienced politicians and a disinformation campaign threaten our government institutions and our very democracy. And the list goes on. If I were to characterize the last 3 or 4 years in a word, and if we're being honest, if I were to characterize the immediate future in a word, I think that word would be scary. I realize that scary is not an uplifting way to lead a graduation speech, but I'll share with you that over the last several years, whenever it seemed another trap door opened up for our society, I often thought of one of the brilliant educators of my time, Mr. Fred Rogers. He explained that when he would see scary things on the news, his mother would tell him, "Look for the helpers. You will always find people who are helping." This evening, it is with great pride and hope that I report that the world is a little less scary. Because when I look out at this group of graduates, I see immensely capable helpers. I see a group that has thrived under unimaginable circumstances. I see a group that is deeply dedicated to the rule of law. I see a group that is brave, that is tested, that is resilient and compassionate. And I see a group that is ready, ready to take on the most profound challenges of our lifetime. Now, there are a lot of misconceptions about attorneys in the world today. I won't perpetuate those misconceptions here. You all will have an entire career to grin politely and laugh a little awkwardly at the lawyer jokes that are told to you. But what I know to be true, and what I hope you know to be true, is that the legal profession is a noble profession. And it is a noble profession because at its core, it is in service to others. As attorneys, you will have the privilege of helping others day in and day out with the specialized knowledge and skill set that you have developed at McGeorge and will continue to hone throughout your legal careers. You will have the privilege of helping your family, your friends, your neighbors, your clients, whether they be multi-million dollar corporations or individuals with ordinary legal problems. You will have the privilege of creating law, passing law, interpreting law, the same law that you have been forced to study, memorize, and apply in these last 3 or 4 years. Of course, with this privilege comes your responsibility to maintain the integrity of the profession and use that same specialized knowledge and skill set to help those who are powerless, who are poor, who are underrepresented and unpopular, and accused. In many ways, the ability to practice law is code for the ability to make a difference, to lift up others, and to make the world a more fair place. So I implore you, graduates, to take this responsibility seriously, whether you do it in your full-time job capacity or in your pro bono work. The American legal system can only live up to its promise when no one is above the law, when no one is beyond its protections, and when everyone has access to justice. So let me close by acknowledging that being the kind of attorney and the kind of helper that I am talking about, being someone who is making meaningful contributions to individual lives and to improving society, it is not an easy lift. And in fact, it may or will prove harder because you are first generation, because you are a person of color, because you are a woman of color, because you are LGBTQ+, because of your faith. But when the world seems scary to you, I encourage all of you too to look for the helpers. If you look around this beautiful room, everyone who has been here for you this evening, everyone who has been with you on this journey is here to help you. So reach out to them the way others will reach out to you. Seek guidance from them the way others will seek yours. And let them help you the way that you will help others. Class of 2022, as you end your law school careers with graduation and simultaneously begin a new chapter with commencement, on behalf of the McGeorge community and everyone here tonight, congratulations. Godspeed. We wish you great success. Thank you.
Thank you so much for those words, Professor Co. So I have the honor of sending y'all out with the energy that I brought y'all back in here with, right? So we finna go home. Y'all ready to go home? I wanna give some closing remarks. First, I wanna send some thank yous. First and foremost, thank you to those of you who supported us watching online. Those of us who are online but are graduates and couldn't make it for whatever reason tonight, we recognize you, we see you, we support you. We're excited to have you and be with you on Saturday. For those friends and family members, again, who you know could not make it for any reason, but you're here online, we appreciate your support. We know that it is unending, and we are excited for you to see what comes of this journey. I also want to send some very practical thanks to Bon Appetit. I want to give a shout out to Andrew, our head chef. Yep, go ahead and clap it up. I want to shout out CM, located off of Franklin Road, Samosa Garden on Florin Road, and South Villa, which is also located on Florin Road. We can shout out our entertainment vendors, Mark Harden at A Big Ticket Sound Experience, Amada Marie at DJ Afghan Lounge, Yolanda Ramos and IMBA. And then we'll also, yep, clap it up. Those performances were stunning, by the way. We loved every moment of it. Let's shout out our staff and faculty. As a matter of fact, I would love it if you all could stand. You helped. Yeah, go ahead and stand. Don't be shy. Staff and faculty. I see y'all in the back not standing. We appreciate you all tonight as well. Shout out our guests, our family. Please stand. Go ahead and stand. We never get tired of standing. Please stand. Guests, family members. All right, that's the last time I make y'all do that. It's okay. Thank you. Want to shout out our graduates for the hard work and determination. This is me speaking to us, but give a round of applause. And then I wanted to give one more shout out, all right? If you guys don't mind, I want to be Auntie Maxine Waters and claim these next 2 minutes. Is that okay? Some of y'all get that reference. So I want to shout out my mother. She was the undercover supporter as she raised 7 kids, and 6 of them secretly thought I was the favorite. I am not. She told me that. From homelessness to educated, my mother was elated to see me admitted to McGeorge and move back to California. We had many hiccups back then because I'm a fighter and I set boundaries and I hate to feel controlled. You know how young people think about their parents. But I was actually her, living out the promises of my ancestors, and she just wanted to protect that journey. So when I pushed her away, she prayed. My mother prayed to see me alive because she knew I would be downtown leading a protest at the sound of Black death. My mother prayed to see me thrive, hoping I would turn back to aid my family. My mother would yell before she would cry because the world had been unkind to her, and she wanted it to be kind to me. She wanted to hold a light to me and paint me with acrylics and resin and gems and eventually with glitter. Yes, queen. My mother always intended for me to be a masterpiece. Although I'm not the favorite son because my mother's love is equity, I think her dream has been realized today. And that's some shit to be proud of. Next, I want to shout out and talk about the journey. Law school was not the most difficult part of the journey. The most difficult part of our individual struggles was where we layered it on top of school. So in an attempt to show solidarity with one another, I want to merge my story with yours. In a symbol of unity, raise a fist with me anytime you can relate or empathize with any item on the following list. I want to reiterate something that where I come from, raising a fist is a sign of unity. It's a sign of empowerment for community struggle. So if you'll join me, we'll give a practice. Raise a fist if you're proud of completing law school. Okay? Another one, put a fist up if you're proud of the community you came to know. Put a fist up if your loved ones had your back. Put a fist up if you almost didn't make it. Put a fist up if you lost someone during the pandemic. Now, let's give a moment of silence to those ancestors watching us with pride. Put a fist up if you cried in your 1L year. Oh, I cried so many times. Put a fist up if you said you wanted out of here. You almost quit, but a quick pep talk brought you off a ledge, and you chose to resist the urge to let self-doubt have an edge on you. Put a fist up for all the displaced people in Afghanistan, occupied Palestine, Haiti, Ukraine, and endless lists of others. Put a fist up for Breonna Taylor. Say her name. Say her name. Say her name. Put a fist up for George Floyd. Say his name. A fist up for Trayvon Martin. Say his name. His name brought me to this stage. His death initially filled me with rage, but a bloodstained banner can be reclaimed if a new generation of legal professionals decide to entertain the notion that we are the solution. We are the world's love potion that's been hidden in confusion, but we are explosive and can never be diluted. Put a fist up if you want world peace at any means necessary. Put a fist up if you want to safe, if you want safe classroom seats from college to elementary. Put a fist up and raise your hands if you signed up to make a difference on this earth. Raise your voices if you signed up to break generational curses. Beat your chest if you're proud of how far you've come. Raise your fist if you believe that victory has won and every hurtful, evil thing can be undone in a world where unity is prioritized. Open your eyes to a life of light and great cause, where you get to participate in giving round of applause to a dream that was dead but came alive in you and in a world that can become brand new. All of you are a special part in a meta-narrative. You are your ancestors' wildest dreams. You are my friends in my greatest time of need. You are my pride and joy in areas I cannot see, and you earned this academic degree. I am proud of how far you traveled to get here, 10 miles in the snow, uphill both ways. Barefooted, two backpacks home, and a torts law textbook. I know you wanted to quit a long time ago, but class of 2022, I'm glad you stayed. Congratulations to us all.